It's Lambo time. It's Lambo time. The bull market's coming and it's right on time. Ignore the news. It's all a ruse. The markets are pumping and the banks are dumping. If you have a Tangent wallet, then that's saying something. What's going on, everyone? Welcome, Rabbit here. And I don't know, did you guys like the song? Did you not like the song? I'm not a singer. Obviously, you can tell if you even heard it there. But if you want some more of that, let me know down in the comments and I'll come up with some more. But regardless, here we are taking a look at the current state of mining, kind of here, but more of my opinion. But I have a feeling that CPU mining is going to dominate this bull run. Now, what do I mean by that? I mean, it's going to be one of the most profitable ways to mine crypto will be on CPUs. It could be ASICs. I think it's a toss-up between ASICs and CPUs. It all depends actually on just how well Caspa price does go when it comes to the ASIC mining. But you know, when it comes to these guys right here, the good old GPUs, I really hope these actually are able to turn on. But the Ethereum level event really killed these. I still think GPU mining is dead. Now, I know we don't want to talk about Ethereum and stuff anymore, but you know, you still can't argue the fact that the most profitable coin for mining in general just hammered out. Everyone bought so much hash rate, and then the coin left. It just ditched everybody and said, see you later. And we're going to look at the difference here. You know, why do I think CPU mining is going to dominate this bull market, and why can't GPUs? So GPUs, yes, can definitely come back. We have been seeing actually some profitability hit up on the GPUs, but there's a major thing a lot of people don't seem to realize, or they forgot, is that power prices are going up across the world, and millions of GPUs, you know, maybe it's just hundreds of thousands, I don't know, but the freaking crap ton of them are still shut off due to high power prices. So let's jump into the workstation. I kind of want to show you what I mean by this. All right, so as for GPUs, here we are at HiveOS. Now, the reason I'm using the HiveOS statistics here is that it is a very popular mining OS, and the majority of home miners and everyone do use HiveOS. Sure, there's other people that do use some other OSs as well as Windows and stuff, but most miners are using HiveOS. It's the most popular one. Anyway, coming into here, we can see the most popular brand for GPUs on HiveOS is 73% Green Team, which is NVIDIA, and we only got 27% of them being on Team Red, which is AMD. Scrolling back up here, out of that 73%, we can see 12% is the RTX 3070 and 9% is the 3060 Ti. So the most common used GPUs is the 3070 and 3060 Ti, and they are NVIDIA GPUs. So now we're over at hashrate.no, 11 cent per kilowatt hour, and things are actually looking not too bad. Yeah, look at that, a 4090 rocking a $1.47 profit. 239 before any type of power cost. That's pretty good here. But you know, 11 cent power for home mining is pretty cheap power if you really think about it. And again, you know, if you only have like 4 cent, 5 cent, 6 cent power or something, you know, you can buy anything and mine. You don't have to worry. GPU mining will always be a thing for you. But most home miners that, you know, aren't mining right now, which is the majority of them, are actually sitting at anywhere between 20 to 30 cent power. I got a lot of emails where 20 to 30 cent power, thousands of GPUs are sitting off and they're waiting for around 60 cent profit before they even think about turning things on. So looking down at the RTX 3070, which is right here, we're only at 34 cent profit at 11 cent per kilowatt hour. If I adjust this into around, let's just say like 26 cent range here, again, you know, upwards of 30, people still aren't mining. The 4090 is now only making 34 cents. We can see a huge drop there, but that's not the thing. The majority of the people out there have RTX 3070s and lots of them. So now we're scrolling back down, trying to find the 3070, and it's in the negatives at 26 power, negative 6 cents. So this is the big uncertainty that we really got to look at, is when we see profitability of about 60% of 60 cents or higher happen at this higher power price of around 26 to 30 cent per kilowatt hour. And on the 3070, you know, we can look at the 4090, whatever, but again, Most of these GPUs are 3070s, 3060 Ti's and stuff. So once we see these profits hit the 60 cents, GPUs will be turning on like crazy. So now, what does that mean? That means that we're going to be at 11 cent per kilowatt hour. We're going to start seeing 4090s and other GPUs start to hit $2 a day in profits. We're all going to be screaming, hallelujah, GPU mining is back. Coins are hitting all-time highs. Next thing you know, the hash rate turns on, and then bam. We could be down to less profits than we are right now when every freaking coin is at an all-time high. That is the huge uncertainty that we don't know about yet, is how many GPUs are going to turn on when it starts getting profitable at them higher power prices. So that's a major unknown. The other thing, obviously, it comes down to how many GPUs actually quit mining. We're seeing lots of GPUs start to go down in price. Sales are going on like crazy. Most likely it's mining farms because they're in lump sums of 50 GPUs here, 100 GPUs. That's not a gamer, guys. So hash rate that's coming from a miner selling to another miner is just hash rate that's set to come on. That is not hardware that's turning off for the bull run. So it's more hardware getting ready to turn on or about to turn on if you know you just bought some or something. So that's another thing to kind of take a look at. So we don't have the profits to see how many GPUs are ready to turn on yet. And there is a lot of them. All right, so you know, that's just my quick 2 cents on how I feel we have to approach GPU mining, is we gotta wait for some of those numbers to see how well it'll actually do. And then once it does hit those numbers, we'll see what happens. Now again, you know, the whole reason behind this is because Ethereum got so darn profitable, everyone just bought everything and then just threw it on Ethereum. And literally, that's pretty much what made Ravencoin, Flux, and all the other coins profitable, is because there was one major hash rate soaker, and that was Ethereum. All these other coins cannot handle the hash rate that's still waiting to turn on. So one thing, it's not going to be easy this time, especially as a GPU miner, is it's not going to be a soaker coin. So I feel if you do not have a coin picked out yet for the bull run, you should probably pick one quick, because it's not going to be a set it and forget it. You're not just going to be like mining Ethereum like you used to. Okay, I went POS, I'll try something else. Oh, we're going to sell the farm, or we're going to move to another coin. And obviously we've seen what happened. We gave you a lot of warning in advance, where I remember telling you guys Ravencoin is going to go in the negative, guys, even though it was over $1 in profits, and all of a sudden bam, what happened? It was even worse than what I was trying to tell you guys it would be. So I'm still kind of throwing the warning up here. When it comes to GPUs, it's going to take every single GPU coin together to make GPUs profitable, because the market cap of all the coins is just so small that, you know, it just can't withstand any of the hash rate that Ethereum had all by itself. So now let's kind of take for the argument on the CPU side and why I think these are going to dominate this bull run. One, we have Zeph that has been doing very well, outperforming XMR. It's peaked at $50 already once. It's come back down, leveling around $20 to $25. But if it continues to explode, I feel it has potential to shoot up to over $400. Now, that would cause a massive hash rate increase and things will go nuts. But keep in mind, block reward reductions are happening across Zeph. I just don't know when they are, because the only thing they have in their emission schedule is slower than XMR. I don't even know what that means. So, you know, obviously slower than XMR means slower than XMR, but we don't know when any emissions are happening. We could wake up tomorrow and the block reward could be less for all we know, because we just don't know when it's going to happen. So that's an iffy part there. But the thing I'm telling you guys about here is all the CPUs that people have bought to mine, they're on. They're not sitting out there. They're not waiting to turn on or anything like that. So for more hash rate to come on, and yes, there definitely will be more as coin prices do rise, but we're not having an influx come in. People are going to have to buy, build, and then put their rig on and check profitability, and then are they going to buy more, and so on. So it's going to be a gradual increase. We're going to have a normal cycle. We're not having a Zeph goes to $400, everyone's making thousands of dollars, and then Zeph says, okay, we're going to POS. That's not what's happening. All these coins that are on CPUs are going to stay on CPUs. That's their whole intention, is to remain on CPUs. So we only have normal cycles right now to kind of deal with, where we're going to hit the bull run, hash rate will pick up, people will build and buy rigs and so on, but then the hash rate will drop off again when we get into the next bear market, and it'll just be, you know, just like a normal cycle, and then back again in 2029. So that's what we're dealing with on the CPU side, and we don't really have to worry, because there isn't all that shut off hardware like the GPUs are actually going to have to deal with. And then obviously we got these guys, the Caspa ASICs, the frickin' machines. You know, Caspa can go to a dollar, it can go to $5, it can go to $1,000 frickin'. I have no idea. That's pretty darn high, but that'd be pretty amazing at the same time. But we don't know how high Caspa will go, but I think when it comes to ASIC profitability, Caspa will be the dominant coin to do so, even though the block rewards are coming down, but it all comes down to the price there. I feel Script is slowly starting to die off. Yes, Dogecoin could possibly go to a dollar or something, but I think a major hash rate increase is set to happen on Script if we do have the hash blades hit, which are insane inefficiencies. We could have an L9 is definitely coming, actually, not could. We are gonna see an L9 later on sometime this year. It's just in the time frame to expect that to happen. Some websites are listing that. And then, you know, other than that, I don't really know what's going on with the other ASICs. Bitcoin mining for home miners, I really feel, is probably one of the worst ideas you could possibly do. You know, don't get me wrong, but Bitcoin ASICs are the least profitable ASIC you could actually have in your arsenal. They're probably going to be worse than GPUs. So yeah, that's just my two cents on Bitcoin ASICs and a home miner. That is also saying I'm coming at 11 cent power, people with 15 cent power, and so on. Again, if you have 4 to 6 to 8 cent power or something, it doesn't matter. You can mine on whatever the heck you want and buy the cheapest garbage you possibly can get your hands on, because power price doesn't matter to you. But we're dealing with home miners on this channel, and that's what I'm trying to stick to here. Now, some other ASICs that are definitely going to be interesting, and I know a lot of you guys are eyeballing, is the recent announcement of Alephium with the Bitmain hackathon thing. So Alephium ASIC is definitely going to be on a lot of people's radar. That is another one that could be making a lot of money. I really think Alephium is going to start pumping once Bitmain definitely starts dropping miners on it. Whether they're pumping it themselves or somebody else, it doesn't matter. The point is the price is going to start pumping. Radiant could see some ASICs here. Nexa, I think, is probably a ways out, but that's definitely going to have ASICs eventually. And that's just another hit to GPUs, is a lot of these major coins here are moving over to the ASIC side of profitability and mining. Here's something I am very excited about, is my very first X3D CPU, and it's coming in on a 7950X. See if I can get in here with the light and stuff. Can you guys kind of see that there? There you go. Hopefully you guys can see that all right. But you know, when it came to the 5000 series X3Ds, they actually weren't that good over the 3 and 5000 series. But I am seeing some numbers from some people here, and this is looking like it's doing about the same, maybe slightly better hash at a decent amount less power than the 7950Xs. And the 7950Xs are absolute beasts when it comes to CPU mining. So I got one. I'm still waiting for the motherboards and stuff to show up here. I do have the two coolers. These coolers are only $23 each. So are they going to keep this thing cool? That's another test we're going to be doing, because that will drop the build costs, obviously, here. And I got a 7950X on the way as well. And, you know, if this thing turns out as good as some of the rumors, I think I definitely should have canceled that. But I'll know for next time, as well as you guys, on what we should build. So I will be getting an updated build list for the 7000 series together pretty darn soon for you guys. I did post one out on Twitter there not too long ago, as well as in my Discord, but I'll try to get one together and actually do a video on building for you guys. And then over that, you know, I think the future of all my builds are only going to be in the 7000 series, at least till the 9000 series comes out sometime by the end of the year. So that pretty much does wrap up this video, guys, but you guys can definitely agree to disagree with anything I just said. Let me know your thoughts and opinions down in the comment section. And if you agree, if you think CPUs will dominate this bull market, I really think there's a lot of specialized AI coming out for CPUs only. I almost said GPUs there, but for CPUs only. There's a lot more coins trying to come out for only CPUs, so there's a lot of interesting stuff emerging when it does come to CPU miners. So thank you for checking out this video, guys. I'll see you on the next one. CPUs are about to buy everyone Lambos.